Hi everyone. Welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, you will learn how to convert a normal image into an awesome oil paint effect with the help of the Real Paint FX tool in Photoshop and a few techniques. I have provided the download link for the Real Paint FX tool, which is absolutely free, so you can download it and follow up with this tutorial. Also in this tutorial, we will cover the installation part of this tool. So let's begin. But before starting, you can see that the image we're gonna use today is kinda blurry, so to fix that we are going to use HitPaw Photo Enhancer. HitPaw Photo Enhancer is a professional level photo enhancement tool that can automatically enhance image quality and resolution with one click, unblur photos, enlarge and upscale images without quality loss, remove noise from images, and restore old photos. It can also colorize black and white images and make cartoon images look clearer. So first open the image. Once done, you can see that it has multiple AI models, which are General, Denoise, Face, and Colorize. But for our image, we will use the Face model. We will keep the mode sharp, and I don't require the Colorize filter as my image already has color. Then set the resolution to 400%. Then we'll keep the high residential acceleration on and click on preview. Now you can see the size difference, also the picture quality of the new enhanced image versus the older image. The blurriness in the face has reduced very much and the face looked more elegant. Now choose the export location and export the image. And here is the final result. Cool, right? Now we will go back to Photo Enhancer and see some other models very fast, and the result is just stunning. You can also visit the HitPaw website. The link is in the description, to check the other products of HitPaw. Also, you can try out this for free and can purchase it with a 30-day refund guarantee policy. Now coming to the installation part, after downloading the file, unzip it, open the folder, and here you will get the installation manual for follow-up. So first open the Tools Patterns and Scripts folder, here you will get Real Paint FX JSX file. Copy that, then open C Drive, then Program Files, then select Adobe. Here I am using Photoshop 23 version, but for you, it might different. So make sure you choose the right Photoshop version, open it, and select the preset folder, then choose Script folder and paste the file into this folder. Once done, then restart Photoshop. Once open, go to File, then Script, and you should see the Real Paint FX option. Now again go back to the Patterns and Scripts folder and this time double-click on Real Paint FX Patterns file with PAT extension, which will install it. Now for the final step, double click on the Real Paint FX Tools file, select the Photoshop version, then you have to select Load as Tools. You have to remember that selecting other options may cause issues. And that's it, you have successfully installed it. Now coming back to the main tutorial, first open the image and click on the lock icon to convert it from a background to a proper layer. Now all you need to do is go to File, then Scripts, then select Real Paint FX. Now you just sit down, cause it will take a couple of seconds to apply all the effects, so I'm speeding it up. And once done, you can see that it has created an awesome oil paint effect, but it needs minor fixes. We will go through all the folders and their functionalities one by one at the time of applying fixes. So let's start with the Revel Back folder, which will help us to get some details from the original image. So first select the mask, then go to Brush, then reduce the size as per your image. Then make sure the opacity and flow are set to 100%, select the foreground color as white, and apply in all those areas where you want that details. If you are still following us, great job. Now we can see that the texture of this image is looking a little hurt, so we will turn off this layer and see it looks more like painting. But I want a little bit of texture, so I will enable the layer and then add a layer mask. Select the foreground color as black this time, then select the brush, and set the flow to 20%, adjust the size and apply on all those areas where you want less texture. It's looking great. Now we will talk about the paint level filters. If you open it, we can see that it has all levels of brush size, lines, and refilers. Disable all except the large brush, and you can see how the paintings will look if painted with a large brush only. Now enable others one by one, and you can see how each of the layers will add details to it. But we don't need all these filters applied in the image in all places. So to do that, we will apply a negative mask in all layers and choose the area that we want to see. So to do that, select each layer except the hard brush and hold the Alt key and add the mask. Once done, we will start with the medium brush layer, select the mask and then select a brush, select the size, then flow to 100%, and apply in the body in some part of the background. Now select the small brush, and I want to apply this filter only to the face and body, not outside. Now select lines and details, and I only want to apply this filter on the face area. And refiler, you can use it to mark some edges. Now you can see the changes, and it's some like real paintings. Now we can talk more about textures. If you open the extra texture files, you can see that currently only broken wall 2 is selected. You can select different textures and see how they looked on your image. Try applying multiple at the same time, and see. Do the same with paint edges and brushed drops folders also. Play with it, that's it. People, I hope you learned something new from this video, then please like and subscribe to our channel, which will motivate us to make more videos like this. Also, check our channel for other Photoshop videos. Bye guys, and happy Photoshopping. See you in the next video.